Hi, it's Pamela Geller, Atlas Shrugs, Stop the Islamization of America, the post-American presidency. As you can see, I have a ton of summer reading. I'm sure you do too, because I know you don't want to see this guy re-elected in 2012, but that's not why we're here today. I'm actually doing a vlog because I think it's critically important that we discuss the Supreme Court of the United States and Obama's picks. Obama's deliberately radical picks. Now, I don't know about you, but if we could just step back, I know that everybody likes to rewrite reality, but if we could step back for just a moment and look at the court. On the one hand, you have the most brilliant judicial minds in the world. You have Justice Roberts, Scalia, a giant, a cerebral giant, a constitutional giant, someone an American can be enormously proud of. Alito, these are the finest minds in the world. And then, on the other hand, you have a freak show. That is exactly what Obama is attempting to do to the court. Make it a circus, a sideshow. Elena Kagan, without even, let's say, delving in, you know how all the little brains go delving into all the paperwork? Just let's talk about her fundamental epistemology, the nature of her knowledge. Here on her college campus, and she was smart, and excuse me, but they should all be smart, okay? Even though Sotomayor, as you may have heard from, even her friend said, was not the brainiest, but a wise Latina. We'll get to her in a minute. Kagan wanted to keep the military off campus. Now, she wanted to keep the military off campus because she did not agree with Don't Ask, Don't Tell. Now, this is a conversation that we can have, and there's no debating it. It's a legitimate argument, but this is my problem with her thinking, her critical thinking. She wants to keep the military off campus on an issue because of an issue like that. I mean, what are you thinking with? She's thinking with her vagina. I mean, who cares? You can debate it, you can fight it, but that's the course you take? That's your scales of justice? You don't agree with Don't Ask, Don't Tell, by the way, developed by the Clinton administration, who she worked for, so don't tell me she's a purist. She's a radical, as exposed by her thesis. That's on atlasshrugs.com. Where she basically idealizes a socialist who became an advocate of the Nazi Party. Now, you could say, oh, she was young and impressionable. Listen, I was young and impressionable. We were all young and impressionable. But that was her influence then. She wanted to know why there was no socialism in the United States. That was one of the opening lines of the thesis. This is what we're putting on the Supreme Court of the United States. They are not there to rewrite the law. They are not there to judicially advocate or adjudicate. Although Sotomayor, not the brainiest, but a wise Latina, said, is on record. We have video of her saying that, you know, everybody knows, that we all do it, you know, judicial activism. Kagan should not be confirmed. How dare they consider these freaks, and I say freaks in a constitutional sense, when they had the audacity, these subversive leftist clowns, to keep off the court one of the greatest judicial minds of our time, Robert Bork. Bork is not on the court, but Sotomayor is? Just stop. And if you could possibly put aside your prejudices, your bias, and look at the concretes, not the obfuscations, not the rhetoric, not the propaganda, which is all the left does, you will notice when arguments are made based on the concrete, the rational always win. That's me. That's you. The reasoned always win. When it's not transparent, when it's obfuscated, when they talk in these broad strokes, you know, when they club you over the head with that guilt nonsense of altruism, which is really a cancer, a pox on the soul of society, that's when you lose your way. And I'm going to ask you to do something that most people don't do. think. It's work. It's like going to the gym for the brain. You have to start to think. This man is making terrible choices. I mean, my only fear is that if she gets voted down, who's he going to put in next? You know what? Here, Obama wanted to filibuster on Alito. Remember that? He wanted a filibuster on Alito, so a filibuster his. He had the audacity when Rick Warren was moderating a debate between him and McCain during the election to say, without missing a beat, when asked who was the worst Supreme Court justice, Clarence Thomas. Another fine, brilliant mind. How racist of Obama. If one thing Obama has brought back into the discourse, it's racism. I don't know about you, but when I was a kid and I went to school, we didn't see stuff like that. We didn't think stuff like that. We were past it. We were past it. That war was won. Civil rights was, it was passed way before I came into my own consciousness, when the veil of oblivion was lifted from my eyes. Everything with him is racial. Everything with him is identity politics. Who cares if they're a Latina? Who cares if they're black? Who cares if they're Jewish? I don't care. I want to know if they are American, if they understand the Constitution, if they understand the rule of law. Will they understand the rule of law? Do they understand that government equals force? And so we use it only to defend our individual rights, our individual property, our basic fundamental principles, of which are being shredded before our very eyes. My greatest disappointment, of course, is in the Republicans. My God, where are these mealy-mouthed, livered, spineless, gutless wonders? We don't have a tenth of the conviction of those leftist subversives. But I'm telling you, Kagan is not qualified. She has never been a judge. She is not qualified. She cannot be on the court. We cannot have a radicalized Supreme Court justice. More than one. We have one already. Because we will live with them the rest of our lives. We have to start speaking up. And I am telling you now in November, if you lose November, if we don't remove Obama's hammer in November, his power, 2012 is a fait accompli. Between Acorn, the illegal voting, the voter fraud, the nonsense, there's been a coup in this country. Why can't we retake the country back by peaceful means? Until they leave us no other choice. But right now, why can't we do it? So I am telling you to urge your senators that they have to vote against this unqualified socialist who never was a judge, whose thesis was to a Nazi-worshipping socialist. And by the way, Nazism was National Socialism. So of course it makes sense that a leftist would worship that, but not on our Supreme Court. So you have the most brilliant on the left and the freak show on the right. What side are you on? Do the right thing. And listen, it's the only picture of him I like. I love this picture of him. I actually sleep with him on my pillow. Yeah. Yeah, I do. I do. It's actually such a good book. This book is so great that I'm rereading it and I'm loving it. Now, let me tell you something. That's no small feat, because when you work on something with Robert Spencer for a year, you can get pretty tired of it, you know? Anyway, the post-American presidency, you'll understand why he's making these SCOTUS choices, these very dangerous, subversive choices. It's up to you. It's up to you now. Well, not just to buy the book, but to vote this woman down. To vote down Elena Kagan. She's ill-equipped. We don't want that court so radicalized that we completely lose our ability to enforce our laws. The Declaration of Independence, the most magnificent document, almost a religious document, the most magnificent document ever written in human history. Listen, have a very happy 4th. I want you to enjoy your life. I want you to eat a frankfurter for me, because I have to keep my figure for the, you know, the book signings. And I have stuff dropping next week. I have some really important campaigns. A lot of things happening, so you better watch Atlas, or you'll be like so not in the know. Love you.